Stop pressing it!
Don't get angry.
Take three couples. Who loves to entertain? Ask them each to throw a dinner party.
Not too much, that's too much.
And score the others in secret.
Well,
today.
It's enormous.
Epic appetites.
Eats four yoghurts in bed before we go to bed every night.
Be with you in a minute, love.
Yeah.
And comedy capers.
You'd be pleased to know I've spent all day raising up door frames.
Nice one.
I think he thinks himself a bit of a clown.
Yeah.
I don't know, might get a bit annoying.
As the couples battle it out to win a £1,000 prize.
I wouldn't have cut your head off Harry Styles, no.
Today on Couples Come Dine With Me, we're in Kent, where one newly engaged couple got together after she nearly ran him over in her car. On it like a car bonnet. And here's another bloke counting his lucky stars.
The way she walked.
Or perhaps not. Dan and his wife Katie have been married for 3.5 tuneful years.
I'm karaoke Kate.
And we dance all night.
Yeah, pass me the earplugs.
I just love karaoke.
I can't imagine anything worse. I hate it. I just think it's embarrassing.
What, that I'm loving life?
Because people walk past me and go, oh, she's at it again, and I'm just standing there like, yep, she's
at it again.
Yeah,
but those people were like happy for me.
They're not.
One thing that does make 6'7" Dan happy is his food.
Enough?
Well, behave yourself, come on, fill it out, more.
Dan's portions are ridiculous. His normal sort of eating plate is actually a platter plate. You'll eat like 2 or 3 chicken breasts for a dinner. He has like 6 eggs in his omelette.
Well, it takes a lot to fuel a 6'7", 200-pound guy.
Monster. Well, that's what you made yourself sound like. 6'7", 200-pound monster.
I didn't say monster, though. You said monster.
Yeah.
I'm a monster.
Time to get to work on their monster menu. And as they don't often cook together, everyone just needs to keep their cool.
Dan not doing as he's told caused the biggest arguments. But to be honest, I'd rather Dan have the authority, so then if we lose, it's his fault.
So on that supportive note, Katie and Dan begin with their dessert, chocolate and coconut banoffee pie.
That sounds like a lot going on, doesn't it?
That sounds very sweet.
Our second couple, wedding DJ Simon and his wife, Lady of Leisure Jackie.
What's that, the chair?
Yeah,
I'm thinking having that one next time.
How relaxing.
I think Simon is what we call a blokey bloke. And you are very manly, aren't you? Very masculine.
Not right now, he's not. Simon also fancies himself as a bit of a comedian.
That's Andy, can you bundle that up? We can use that later in the recipe.
Yes. And he takes his comic inspiration from one man in particular.
I've got one or two people call me Del Moy. Mont Blanc.
No. Bonnet de douche,
yeah. What do you call a gorilla called Keith?
Don't know. What do you call a gorilla called Keith?
Keith.
You're a patient woman, Jackie. First up for our hosts is dessert. And Dan, the 200-pound monster, has a spot of biscuit bashing to do for the base.
So you want me to destroy these?
Yes.
At least you can show the biscuits who's boss. For the topping, Katie combines dark chocolate with shop-bought caramel.
I think you've done enough now, babe. I reckon you're all right.
To complete the base, Dan heats a solid chunk of creamed coconut.
I've heard of creamed coconut, but I've never seen it like that before. It's like a lump of clay.
I'm sure it'll look better melted. Or perhaps not.
What's that?
Well, it's because it's based. I think it's meant to do that. It'll add to the taste.
It's going wrong already.
Mixture successfully melted, Katie adds the crushed biscuits and assembles with the topping in ramekins. She'll add coconut, banana and cream before serving later. Next, it's onto their starter, goat's cheese parcels with homemade chili jam.
It's quite an easy starter, isn't it?
Well...
Pinch button.
Our third and final couple are fun-loving Paul and Claire. Together for 10 years, they live in the house they designed themselves. Oh, it's lovely. All right, stop staring now.
My first impression of Paul was a crazy, crazy, funny guy.
Must have been the moves. And they love their dancing so much, they even got married in Ibiza.
I'm hoping that the people we meet are going to be up for a laugh and bubbly and fun.
Ta-da!
In Katie and Dan's kitchen, they're making their chili jam with red peppers.
I would expect the homemade chili jam to be homemade because it says homemade.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. What are you doing?
What?
And then go down the sides. It's the easiest way.
I'm very capable of cutting a pepper.
I'd stay out of it if I were you. Blended with garlic, chilies and ginger, the pepper mixture is added to the heat. Next, they prepare the goat's cheese.
What noise do goats make?
I'm not very good at doing goat.
You can do a really good horse.
I'm not doing a horse.
Oh, go on.
I'm not doing a horse.
Well, that's uncanny. The cheese is combined with caramelised onions and thyme, and all that's left are the pastry parcels.
If they make the phyllo pastry, I will be impressed.
I've bought phyllo pastry, I'm not going to lie, I'm not going to pretend I've made it. It's horrendously difficult to make, and I think I've got enough on my plate.
Giant plate.
Without worrying about making my own pastry as well.
The cheese will be parceled up later. Main is crispy pork belly, wasabi mash, sweet potato and parsnip shavings.
Crikey. Pork belly, that's what we're doing.
I told you to do lamb, didn't I? Oh.
That is a big bit of meat.
Surely just a snack for you. Dan adds oil to the pork.
It's all about just having a bit of a moment with the pig. Yeah.
Okay, you have your moment.
Rub down over, they season with Chinese five spice.
Do I think there's enough pork? It's enormous.
Are you sure?
Even though, look, that is probably the size of my upper leg.
Lovely. Pretty sure the guests won't be going hungry tonight. Lastly, Dan needs some advice.
Nice long strips like that.
I thought you were the pepper chopping expert.
Is that good?
Well, it's not very equal, is it?
It's not very equal.
Well, the bottom's bigger than the top.
You want them perfectly symmetrical.
What are you doing?
You told me to cut them in
half.
No,
in down the middle.
How can I cut that down the middle? All right, okay.
That's cutting.
I'll spend an hour.
Well, if you stop arguing with me, you do it. I'm actually surprised that we haven't rowed.
Well, we've put a little row, but.
Yeah, bickering's different. I actually thought that we would get. You would do something that would really annoy me, apart from the peppers, slightly.
Off you pop to get ready.
I'm looking at the menu. I'm not fazed by that, to be fair.
This should seal the £1,000 easily for us.
Don't say that.
Let's do this.
Let's get this party started. You need to open the door, really, like, be happy. Hello, welcome
I'm
to the
house. I'm always happy.
It's debatable.
You want me to be over the top?
No, I just want you to be normal.
First to arrive are Simon and Jackie. Remember, Dan, just act normal.
Hello. Hi. Hiya. Come in. I'm Danny. Nice to meet
you. Nice to meet
you.
Nice to meet you, Dan. I'm Jackie.
Nice to meet you, Jackie.
Hi, Danny. I'm Simon.
Hello, mate. Come in. Lovely.
Think you got away with that?
Let me go and get you guys a drink.
That'd be great.
All right, no worries.
Thank you.
Looks nice, doesn't it? Good start. Bit too tall. I've seen him dug underneath the door frames. Hopefully he'll bang into one night during this week. That will be funny. I do love people banging into things.
That's not very nice.
Well dressed.
How old are they?
Late 40s.
What are they called? What are their names?
He is called Simon.
Okay.
And she is called Jackie, and I can't believe I remembered that.
Nor could I.
I did.
Well,
I
really Jackie and Simon.
Jackie and Simon. There you go.
Hello, nice to meet you.
This is Katie, my
wife. Nice to meet you, Katie.
Hiya. Lovely
to meet you.
Hiya.
Hello, Katie.
Hello.
Sorry.
Oh, it's straight for a kiss.
Yeah. Bit forward.
Cheeky. Putting their best foot forward, it's Paul and Claire. Remember, Dan, just act normal.
Hello. Welcome. I'm Danny. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Cheers, mate.
Hi, mate. What's your name, sorry?
Paul.
Paul, nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you. I'm Katie.
I'm Claire. Nice to meet you.
All right, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Nice to meet you.
Katie.
The tall bloke, he's Dan. Yeah. That's the most original tall joke you've had fun at you.
The most original... Do you know what? There hasn't been an original one. That's what's really? So annoying about it.
When I first met Dan, I looked at him, oh, my God, look how tall he is, and I didn't realise.
Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
Oh, yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
Lovely.
Simon, yeah. I know I talk a lot, but actually he talks more than me. And I'm like, wow, I've met my match here, because actually he's going to out-talk me.
Coming up.
Babe, that's way too much mash.
Are you for real?
Hearty helpings.
To have your plate stuffed with food is quite off-putting.
And confusing crushes.
I did have a 6-foot cardboard cutout of Harry.
Just really, really obsessed with him.
He's a teenager, isn't he? He's 12, is he?
It's night one in Kent, where Dan and Katie are out to impress two other couples with some hearty portions in a bid to win a grand.
Cheers.
Stop pressing it.
Don't get angry.
Upstairs, guests Paul and Claire have a root around.
What's this? One Direction. One D. Oh, I love it. I love One Direction.
Why have they got One Direction? Who's he then? That's all of them, innit?
Do you think it's her or him?
I don't know. Have they got kids?
No. Yeah, do you think it belongs to Dan or a child?
How old are they?
I don't know. About 30. But like now that. I've seen it. You like watching it, I think I've got one for Christmas.
Downstairs, the parcels are ready for plating.
I'll get the way. This is hot.
Two each. Crikey, I hope they're hungry. Here it is, goat's cheese parcels with homemade chili jam.
Let's rock and roll.
Let's do it, baby.
Dig in.
The pastry's lovely. Mm. It's really nice.
We have cheated for the pastry, unfortunately.
Oh, Kate.
Oh. It's lovely.
It is shop-bought pastry, only because we just purely didn't have enough time.
A little bit of a soggy bottom.
Yeah, and a soggy top, I thought, to be honest. But
No, the top for me, on mine, was perfect. It was nice and crisp, but it was a little bit undercooked underneath.
Pastry's lovely, jam's lovely. I just really don't like goat's cheese.
That is the danger. No.
I think two parcels was too much.
Yeah, to be fair, when you're having a three-course meal, I would prefer just to have one.
And funnily enough, Simon knows a joke about portion control.
I've been on a diet for about a month. She was ironing my shirt on a walk the other day. I realised I had to lose weight.
I got it. Don't worry, mate. Yeah.
Like dad jokes, aren't they? The kind of
terrible dad jokes.
I bought a rowing machine. I'm doing a mile a day.
Yeah.
7 miles away from my house by the end of the week.
I think he thinks himself a bit of a clown.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah. It might get a bit annoying. We'll see.
A stand-up comic here, aren't we?
I'm standing up. You heard the first start. Don't do the short jokes again.
Simon, he... I know his jokes. I mean, his jokes are quite bad.
I've had better audiences, to be honest. I think I pitched them a bit too high, a more cerebral level. I had to go down to the cracker jokes and then I got a laugh.
What are you finding that way for? I can have that for lunch tomorrow.
Can we just keep it?
Definitely keep them. They've not even been touched. They're fresh.
What about this one?
Yeah, and keep that. Put it all on one plate.
No need for a compost bucket in this house. With the pork ready, it's time for Dan to serve up.
Hey, that's way too much mash.
Are you for real?
That's enough now.
And with a mammoth slab of meat, the food mountain is complete. Pork belly with wasabi mash.
Thank you.
Loosen those belt buckles, everybody.
I've been looking forward to this one. I saw this on the menu.
That's pressure.
And it was an Asian mix, and I went, right, mash is my favourite anyway. Love wasabi, so shame about the first one, but this one's looking forward to.
Again, they was a little bit too much on the plate.
To have your plate stuffed with food is quite off-putting.
So, guys, what do you think?
I like the pork, but I'm not the biggest pork fan. It wasn't really my cup of tea, really. It's a bit fatty, and I don't really like that, and maybe a bit chewy.
Disappointment of mine.
Was you?
Yeah, because it wasn't crispy for a start.
No.
They do seem quite big portions that you've got. No, which is fine. I mean, I think it's different, but...
When they come and see us, they might be going, getting a kebab on the way home.
We buy, 24 eggs in a shop?
24?
No, that's a lie. Four boxes of 12. 48.
Sorry, for what, a week or...?
Well, you normally go every 5 days.
Six a day.
Six eggs a day?
What do you do? That is ludicrous.
Six eggs a day? I'd have his cholesterol checks myself.
Yeah.
He eats four yoghurts in bed before we go to bed every night.
Really? Before you go... What, while you're in bed?
In bed.
Four
in
yoghurt.
Bed, yeah. Four yoghurts. Be with you in a minute, love.
Yeah.
I have never eaten four yoghurts. Three at the most.
Yeah, we've got four skis to get through.
Back at the table, talk takes a different direction.
When we were upstairs in your bedroom, we looked in your wardrobe.
Oh, yeah.
And we found a One Direction towel and top.
It's definitely not mine.
Sure?
No.
I've got weird obsessions with boy bands, but Harry Styles is like my ultimate.
Okay.
I did have a 6-foot cardboard cutout of Harry. That used to...
In your bedroom?
It was a little bit weird in the night when you woke up and there was just like this Harry looking at you.
Yeah, half asleep.
Are you being serious?
No, she's being serious, mate, yeah.
I had my mum and Nan for dinner and I put him at the table next to my mum. I sat him on the chair.
She was really
really obsessed with him.
He's a teenager, isn't he? He's 12, is he?
Harry came to a bit of a sad end.
Did you have to get rid of him? Or?
Well, I did it
with style.
Tell him what you did.
Might have had a bit too much to drink. And it was all your friends said to me, why don't you cut his head off? Because I was doing a barbecue with a big chef's knife. And I said, why not? So
I wasn't there at this point, and I walked. So
she came out, and it was. I was on the last cut.
I wouldn't have cut your head off Harry Styles. No, I wouldn't let you have Harry Styles in the house. It's a boy.
How old are you? No, I don't even ask.
She's 14. Yeah.
Katie and Dan.
I feel they were very friendly, really welcoming.
There is a lot of leftovers, but I think that's
the fact that you've got massive portions.
But I don't consider them to be remotely massive portions.
Yeah, but to people that don't eat the same quantity of food as you, they are big portions.
Not everyone's a 6'7" monster.
It's all on dessert now. It's up to you to make or break. Perfect, look at that.
Pressure's on. Bananas for the banoffee pie, nicely caramelised. Dessert is ready. Coconut and chocolate banoffee pie.
Get to the bottom. Don't bang it.
It is quite hard. I think I
should
probably go out of the fridge a bit quicker.
It's quite
a heavy
face.
But does anyone want to borrow my hammer? It's ridiculous.
Yeah, but you don't have to highlight that fact.
No, you don't. With the evening drawing to a close, there's no escape from one last Simon joke.
What about the bloke who goes into the doctors and he says to the doctor, he says, I think I'm a moth. He says, you think you're a moth? He says, yeah. He said, you don't need a doctor, you need a psychiatrist. He said, I know, but I was on the way there, but I saw your light on.
Because that's what a moth would do. Taxis!
The top was quite nice, but when you try to break into the bottom, you needed a pickaxe, didn't you, really?
It was very hard.
I'm pleased it's over.
Job done.
Yeah, I'm relieved. I think now we can relax for the rest of the week.
Food was a little bit of a disappointment. Way too much food for us.
Yeah, the dessert was, I would say, rock solid. It was a little bit too hard. So based on that reason, we're going to give them...
A 12. Presentation was good.
Yeah, but it was too much.
It was too much put on the plate.
So tonight, we're going to give it a 13.
So Dan and Katie start off the week with a disappointing 25 out of 40, but at least there's plenty of leftovers. It's day two and the turn of Simon and Jackie to host, and their guests are preparing themselves for another night of one-liners.
I love Simon's bad jokes. I find them hilarious.
In that individual dose one night, it was okay, but...
Yeah.
After another night, if he carries on and gets worse. I think he's got the potential to be annoying.
Not sure Dan's going to appreciate Simon's hilarious twist on his menu, then.
Tonight's menu is French-themed, and the only reason I've done that is because I want to see him trip over the French words. Because most of them I can't even say. I struggle with English.
And the first French curveball is Coquille Saint-Jacques.
I'm guessing it's French, because it's three French words, but I have absolutely no idea what that is.
I think it's oysters.
Scallops, actually, with a white wine sauce, for which Jackie mixes fried shallots with white wine and cream. Oh, and Simon's been trusted with the cheese grater.
There's a lot relying on me now, ain't you?
Yeah.
Still, what could possibly go wrong?
Oh, you joker. The scallops and prawns are added to the sauce, and the shells get their potato piping.
Perfect, darling.
Yeah.
Little angel kisses. Bonne la douche.
Bonne la douche. Cosmic, dear boy.
He who dares, Rodney! With toasted breadcrumbs and Gruyere to finish, they'll oven bake them just before serving.
Beautiful.
Get ready for a win.
Mm-hmm. It's on to the main, the poitrine de porc avec des pommes de terre boulangère, which roughly translates as our second pork belly in 2 days. What? No mange two?
Poitrine? How do you pronounce that?
Poitrine.
Poitrine.
I don't know.
It's Battle of the Pork.
Yeah.
I don't even really like pork.
It's all about the crackling for these two, so Jackie starts by scoring the fat.
If we can get it crispy, like you usually do, then we're going to win.
Plenty of salt will help with the crispiness.
Did you get that from our favourite butcher?
I did.
I went in there the other day and I said to him, can I have that sirloin off that top shelf? And he said, no. And I said, why not? He said, steaks are too high.
The steaks are too high. Trust Simon to ham it up.
Right, gorgeous.
Thank you.
In you go.
crisp up for me nicely.
Jackie will keep the pork tender by slow roasting it on a bed of onions, white wine, stock and herbs for 4 hours.
Beautiful.
For the potato boulangère, chopped onions are added to sliced potatoes along with Gruyere cheese and butter. It'll be baked later. Lastly, dessert. Pudding au pain special de Jackie, or Jackie's special bread pudding, which is made with chocolate chip brioche.
A French take on a bread and butter pudding, I guess.
Try bien.
What do you want me to do now, darling?
Right, I want you to cut the brioche down the middle, donk, 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 drop down.
Brioche diced. Jackie mixes cream, milk, sugar and orange liqueur, which she'll add before baking later. Et voilà! Job done. Just time for a quick change before greeting their guests.
OK, darling. Let's knock them dead.
Let's go.
Ready for the soiree ahead, it's Paul and Claire. Bonsoir, mes amis.
Hi, Paul. Claire, lovely to see you. Come in. You look fabulous.
So do you.
Thank you, darling.
Nice to see you.
And you. You don't look bad either, mate.
You're
how are you doing?
Good, yeah, good.
Nice to see you. Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Have a great night.
Oh, yeah.
I'm looking
forward
to
it.
Yeah.
We'll
have a great night.
A bit of banter from you boys, no doubt.
And last to join the lols, it's Dan and Katie.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
You're fabulous, aren't
you? Nice to see
how are you?
You.
And lovely to see you again. Hello, Dan.
Hello, mate. Good to see you
again.
Good man.
Nice to see you.
Thank you
Come
very much.
Through.
Oh, no tall jokes so far.
You'll be pleased to know I've spent all day raising up door frames.
Ah, there we go.
Simon, still bringing out the tall jokes.
We've got a present for you.
Yeah, we've got something.
Yeah.
Oh, that's very good, eh?
In my bag.
This is just for you. Sorry, Jackie.
Oh, that's okay.
Thought you'd appreciate it.
Unfortunately, I've read it.
Yes, and several others, I'm assuming. Coming up, French fiction.
Where is the French in this? I'm sort of slightly confused.
The pig was actually French. We imported it especially.
I really don't know anything about French.
And claims to fame.
I did a wedding at Madonna. Danced on my dance floor.
Yeah. A bit clutching at straws there, I think, Simon.
It's night two of our couples competition in Kent, where host Jackie and Simon are throwing a French-themed evening in the hope of winning un mille livre. That's £1,000.
Yes.
With the host busy.
Bon appétit.
Getting you with the French.
Dan and Paul have found their own amusement.
Oh, look at that photo.
DJ.
That's an old photo, isn't it? What will your family and friends remember about your wedding?
Wedding disco.
The disco. Make sure the memories are good, from celebrity weddings to royal balls in huge marquees to village halls.
That probably makes sense now with the corny jokes.
He's your cliche wedding DJ. He's got the personality, the cheesiness.
In the kitchen down below, the French starters are good to go.
Get them out then. Get them babies out.
Oh, looking good.
Looking good, looking good. Don't drop them.
And here it is, Coquille Saint-Jacques.
They look fabulous, aren't they? Right. Let's go and do it.
Let's do it. Thank you.
That is Coquille Saint-Jacques.
Did everybody know what this was when you read the menu?
No. No. We went from oysters.
I really thought I did know what it was.
You said it was oysters, didn't you?
We didn't have a clue, but when I started thinking about the French thing, it suddenly dawned on me in a horrible sinking feeling that it might be snails.
It's French, right?
Not being funny, it's quite well known. You need to get out more, Paul.
I'll tell you what I do.
I was surprised none of them knew of Coquille Saint-Jacques because Marks and Spencer's there.
I feel like I'm doing keyhole surgery.
I've not realised how big your hands are. Just looking at it, it's huge.
The fork was ridiculous. I mean, I lost it several times. I forgot I was holding it. It was so tiny. It was like something from The Borrowers.
How you finding it, Paul? All right.
Yeah. No, I do. I know it is.
Good.
It's good.
The mash around the side was great. The prawns individually, it's just that texture I sort of had to struggle with. But they've done a great job.
The actual sauce that it was cooked in, I thought, was lovely.
Yeah, the sauce was nice. I just think they used a pipette to put it on because there was nothing there.
That's French, isn't it?
Yeah,
it matches the menu.
Yeah, there you go. See, I'm getting down with the French dips.
Magnifique! At the table, Paul wants to know more about Simon's job.
So when we was in your room just back then, we just saw some decks and some very nice sort of cards that you give out and you do wedding
That's
parties.
Right, I'm a wedding DJ, yeah.
Yeah, I've got one here, actually.
Oh, yeah.
I assume that I could take one as they...
Of course, yeah. I've got 8,000.
I noted it said on the fly that you've done lots of celebrity stuff, so what...
I did. My main celebrity, the main claim to fame, I did a wedding that Madonna danced on my dance floor.
Wow!
It's a little bit tenuous.
Hang on.
She was actually staying in a hotel where I was doing a wedding, and she come and danced on my dance floor. I didn't see her, but one of the waiters come up and said, did you realise that Madonna was out on your dance floor for a while?
Yeah. Bit clutching at straws there, I think, Simon. Do you ever do any of your jokes on
the line? No, never, no. I save them for my friends.
Oh, really? Oh, we're honoured.
Yeah. Right. He seems to have toned down this evening, though. Like, he hasn't done so many of the joke, which... I think puts down to perhaps the pressure of having their evening and their... No, I think it's their evening. Thank you.
I'm pleased that they enjoyed it. It wasn't an easy start, was it? We didn't do an easy start, so I think that would hopefully give us a pat on the back and a few points.
So it's straight on to the second pork belly of the week. The parsnip puree is served up.
Not too much, it's too much.
Don't tell me.
Don't tell her.
That's too much. It's more than you give us the other night.
It's not.
We've done as best as we can. The pork seems really tender. The boulanger... Boulanger. It's come
out
lovely.
Well.
It is boulanger potatoes rodanis with poitrine de porc. Or pork belly. Slightly daintier portions than last night.
For me, that was more of a kind of startery size portion. Honestly, that was a starter size portion for me.
Where is the French in this? I'm just sort of slightly confused because this is quite an English dish. It's beautiful, but I just want to know.
The pig was actually French. We imported it especially. For the occasion.
They really don't know anything about French, and it was just to make the menu sound better.
It's lovely. It's cooked brilliantly.
Yeah, I've got to say, we've both done pork belly.
Yeah, you did.
This is what I wanted. This is what I wanted mine to be like.
I think we won the pork off.
Oh, without a doubt.
Simon and Jackie definitely won the pork off.
Back at the table, Simon's got something to get off his chest.
I've got a real bugbear of labels, especially in ladies' clothing, especially in ladies' underwear. You get these dinky little pants and bras with great big labels hanging out. So I turned out her underwear drawer and sliced off every single label. Yes, she's got lots of knickers and bras, I promise you. It took me about a day to do it all.
He's got too much time on his hands.
But Simon's not the only one with a bizarre obsession.
Light switches. They need to be centralised. I don't like if a light switch is not in the right place in the wall, so it kind of winds me up a little bit.
The thing with light switches is they're usually close to the door frame, so that as you walk in, it's just within reach, so you don't have to then walk halfway down the room because it's dead in the middle.
What about the light switches on the wall over there? Are they offensive?
I would prefer if they were centralised, but...
What, in the middle of the wall?
In the middle of the wall.
Sometimes.
They're not a feature, you know.
Swiftly moving on to dessert.
Hopefully they won't find this too sweet and sickly.
No. And we won't need a toffee hammer to break into it.
Et voilà, pudding au pain special de Jackie. Uh-oh, another disappointing portion for Dan.
There you go, Dan.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
I translated it as bread and butter pudding.
Oh, so now you speak French.
I do speak a little, so it did come out like that on the thing. But awesome.
Nice. Good. Yeah,
lovely. Lovely.
Right, Dan, as we know, you've got a healthy appetite, and it is your favourite.
Well, saved you a bit.
There you go, my son.
Wow.
Enjoy.
Fill your boots, big boy.
So to stop there, wow. Because... I know he's full height. I'm a growing lad, and I need to get to that
height.
I would
some
like
more.
A little bit extra, please, and my plate too.
I mean, you're going to fall out, mate. I'm not impressed.
You've got a lot left over there.
Should we stop messing about? Yes. Fill your boots.
I don't think I've got a choice, have I?
Taxis!
They offered me up it was like a trough of extras, and I was like, yeah,
this is awesome.
It was cooked and crisp. I haven't got a complaint, and yeah, it was great.
You've done really well in the kitchen.
Mate, can we do that little less patronise, Lee? Thank you. You're shocked. Why are you shocked?
The main was fantastic. The dessert was fantastic. And so we're going to give them a fantastic 16.
The main course was lovely. Perhaps not enough for Dan's normal size portions. No,
but they made up for it with dessert, which was absolutely awesome. So
tonight we're going to give a 14.
Which means Simon and Jackie storm into the lead with 30 out of 40. Incroyable! It's the final day in Kent, and the heat is on hosts Paul and Claire to beat last night's menu.
I think after our evening, I think they know the pressure's on, and I think they're going to up their game a little bit.
Jackie and Simon definitely raised the bar.
My parents are sort of Jamaican, and sort of Claire's more English.
So we're going to have a Jamaican starter, English main course, and then a mix for the dessert.
And they're starting with that dessert, Jamaican ginger pudding with homemade ginger ice cream.
Ginger could be a winner for me.
I don't like ginger.
Neither
don't like ginger. You're not a big fan.
Big fan of ginger, to be honest, no.
But so, I will try it. There's no way I wouldn't try it, because it may just be a hint of ginger.
Let's hope Paul and Claire don't overdo it with the ginger in their ice cream, then. Claire starts with the custard and clotted cream.
Creamy. Yuck.
Love it, don't you?
With a vote of confidence from Paul, Claire adds ginger syrup and mixes it all together. The stem ginger will be added later. Next up is the ginger pudding.
50 grams.
Yeah, that's 50.
So a bit less.
No, that's fine. That's fine. That's about 51, so that's all right.
You sure?
You've got to be exact though, haven't you?
No, that's fine. That'll be all right. Okay. That we don't normally share the cooking. She's got her way and it has to be totally exact, whereas I'll just mix and just do what you got to do.
Paul?
Yes, it still comes out the same.
Is that right like that?
Yeah, you've got to weigh something with this bow on.
So, doesn't it meant to start at the beginning?
Yeah, but you've got stuff in it. It can't stay...
No, but no, oh.
Yeah, but, oh, no, the bowl. But the bowl weights a certain level, so it's got to be on zero.
Also, Claire's the precise one, is she? They make a base of egg and dark brown sugar and stir it together.
A bit gooey.
Milk and black treacle are added and the flour mix is added in to complete the pudding.
We're just hoping now, it's out of our hands, that the oven decides to make it rise.
Pudding done, it'll be baked before dessert is served tonight. So it's on to Paul's Jamaican starter. Saltfish fritters, ackee and saltfish with jerk chicken wings.
Is saltfish fish?
Yeah.
I don't like saltfish. I don't like
fish.
You
don't like fish?
No.
Makes sense. Paul starts by cooking the salted cod in boiling water.
Yeah.
Yes, boiling water, Paul.
That was hot.
Please don't go putting your fingers in boiling water at home. Fish cooking, he tackles the jerk chicken wings.
I'm not a fan of chicken wings. They're very fiddly. There's not much meat going on.
This is the black pepper from Jamaica, right? My grand sends me.
That's strong.
Yeah, so I won't put too much in. Woo. The pepper is quite... gets up your nose.
I wouldn't personally put anything on a menu where you need to pick up with your fingers.
You're going to hate eating these then, Jackie. Paul adds jerk paste to the chicken wings.
And then it's just making sure that all the... seasoning just goes all the way through.
The wings are left to marinate, and it's back to the saltfish, which is added to a stir-fry mix and will form the fritters later.
It's good.
Yeah,
it smells lovely.
The ackee dish will be fired up just before serving.
Do you like ackee? You've had it, you said.
We had it in Jamaica, I think, didn't we?
I can't remember.
Yeah, it is not very memorable. No.
Clearly not. And finally, time to prepare the main. T-bone steak with garlic roasties and watercress salad.
Here we have locally sourced, 40-day matured, French trim, Côte de Bœuf.
Mmm, looks good.
Just enough there for Dan's portion.
Well, I'd be very disappointed if he doesn't ask how we all want it cooked, because that's the big thing with steak.
Are we going to do it rare?
Well, it will be cooked medium.
Is it medium?
For everybody. Let's hope he asks us, or Claire, asks us how we like it cooked.
Our way, or the highway.
So I'm going to leave it out to get to room temperature.
Okay.
And then I'm going to season it later on and we'll sear it on the frying pan.
So, with nearly no preparation to be done for the main until tonight, all that's left is for Paul and Claire to greet their guests.
Right, let's get ready to rumble.
With the hosts ready for action, Simon and Jackie are first to appreciate the plush surroundings.
It's impressive.
Stunning.
It's really nice. Gorgeous.
Come in.
Lovely to see you.
And you.
You look lovely.
Gorgeous.
Oh, you look gorgeous.
Hello, darling. You look wonderful.
Thank you.
Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.
Good to see you. Another wonderful evening. Yeah. Yeah.
Last to arrive at their humble abode are Katie and Dan.
I am absolutely...
I've wept.
Gobsmacked.
It's absolutely beautiful.
This is unbelievable. I've only ever driven past houses like this and never actually been in one.
Yeah,
so it's been a treat to actually go inside one and just see what they look like.
I'm very well.
You had a good day?
Yeah, very good. You look lovely.
Thank you very much.
Hello, good to see you.
Good to see you. You look lovely.
Don't worry, Claire, you look lovely too.
When we first saw the house, I was pretty gobsmacked, to be honest.
Yeah, I was absolutely dumbfounded. I was expecting more, to be honest. It's all right.
Can I actually borrow your block?
That's your funniest
pot?
One, yeah.
That's perfect for me. Come here, Luke. Shortly. How's it feel?
How's it feel
being
this?
First time having someone up to your own
height. Do you feel important?
I do now, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Would you like me to help you down?
Please.
Coming up, meticulous meat eaters.
It's a touch overdone for me.
For me, this is a little, well, fairly overdone.
I knew it was personal, but we didn't realise how personal steak is for people cooking.
And the winners are revealed.
In first place, we have...
It's the final night in Kent, and hosts Paul and Claire are battling it out against two other couples to win a £1,000 prize.
Yeah.
Whilst Paul and Claire sweat it out in the kitchen...
Pressure's on.
Doing well.
The others have a nosy round their impressive surroundings.
I've got to try this. It's like getting a swimming pool.
No wonder this is great.
I might actually be able to have my legs spread fully out.
Oh,
this is awesome. Dritten. Paul would let me come and have a bath.
For Dan to fit in a bath that, you know, that would accommodate his length, shall we say.
The bath was like a swimming pool for me, wasn't it? Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, dressing up.
That's
like
my kind of bag.
Yeah, get your dressing up going.
Ooh.
What have we got here? Do you know what? I saw the fez and I thought, I knew exactly what was going to happen. I thought, Simon's going to grab that, Simon's going to put it on and he's going to give it, Tommy Cooper.
That'll do me. Just like... Not like that, not that.
And what are you going to give it in those?
Perfection.
Oh, God.
You look like a young Mick Jagger.
Thank you very much. They're chafing a little bit, I'm not going to lie.
The sight of Dan in his pink knickers will live with me for a long time.
These are definitely going to go in my pocket.
With Dan relaxed in his pink pants, Paul and Claire are anything but as they serve up their Jamaican starter.
What are you doing?
I just dropped it on there. Sorry.
Smooth. And here it is, ackee and saltfish fritters and some slightly scrawny jerk chicken wings. Sorry, Dan.
The level of spice is brilliant. I love spicy food.
Do you?
Yeah, so I'm really glad that it's got that kick. It's lovely, the jerk seasoning.
I don't like chicken on a bone. I normally get Jackie to pull it apart.
Lucky Jackie.
She quite happily eats anything on a bone.
Flavour was nice, I enjoyed that, but... I would prefer not to be picking up food and eat with my fingers when I'm at dinner parties with people.
I thought it was going to be chicken wings, like a bowlful. It wasn't even worth eating, to be honest. It was so minute.
With Dan's huge appetite unfulfilled, talk turns to Paul's line of work.
We was wondering what you actually did for a living. We did contemplate lottery winners.
I was a broker for 20-odd years. I did that up until about 2 years ago. And I've got my own sort of courier business as well.
And then Claire, she's setting up her own business now as well.
The last 2 years, I've been training to be a beauty therapist.
You don't mind a pedicure now and again?
Only before holiday. don't stitch me up, come on.
Dan, you're not alone, mate. we are big fans of the pedicure. I'm not a secret metrosexual. I think most people who know me know that I'm in touch with my feminine side.
Oh,
so
he's right out there.
I was trying to see if there's going to be a one-liner there, but he actually means it.
No, I actually mean it, yeah.
You were joking.
Starter finished, it's back to the kitchen for Paul and Claire.
We could have played it safe and, you know, put a boiled egg on there and everyone would have liked it, but I don't think we would have got points for putting a boiled egg on there. Yeah, well, I mean, everyone likes a boiled egg, right? So, you know, I don't think we should have played it safe, no?
OK.
Well, they're certainly taking a gamble with the main.
We're going to cook the steak all the same.
There's a bit of brown and there's a bit of pink. You know, there's a bit for everybody.
As long as they like it medium to well done. Here it is, T-bone steak with garlic roasties and watercress salad.
Here you go, sir.
Thank you, mate.
Oh, yeah, go on, dig in.
I was expecting a half a cow on the plate and I end up with probably three shavings of a mouse. I'm very hard to please with my steak. I've quite regularly sent steak back. The record is four times, but it's a touch overdone for me. I was shocked they didn't ask how the steak was going to be done.
For me, this is a little, well, fairly overdone. It's still tasty, it's still nice, I'll still eat it, but if I was able to, yeah, come on, this is me.
I knew it was personal, but we didn't realise how personal steak is for people cooking.
It seasoned really well. Mm. Yeah, and the watercress salad and the little carrots on the side are lovely. Again, presentation is really good.
I think it had the elements to be really good, but I think it was disappointing.
Perhaps they should have cooked the steak to order, but talk moves on to the guests' discoveries upstairs.
So we had a little mooch around the house earlier and we found quite a big bag, actually, in your bedroom of fancy dress outfits.
Pinch something.
It wasn't the knickers, was it?
Take these home. They fit beautifully. I've still got them in my pocket. If they don't ask for them back, then they obviously don't miss them, so...
I hope they're closing the door. They're yours. Oh, I'm sorry about that.
I haven't admitted anything. Nothing at all.
We are quite big party animals. We got married in Ibiza, and we do go to Ibiza quite a bit.
We met in a club, didn't we?
We did.
Well, actually, we met in a nightclub as well. She was just probably just happy, just waving around and dancing, and I'm sort of trying to edge in there. And I remember I was actually having a little dance-off with this guy. So I won the dance-off and won her heart, so it's cool.
Aww.
So now you all know that I met Claire with a little dance-off. Just thought maybe later on we could get some music going and a couple of us boys can have a little dance-off in front of the girls and just show our moves.
That was my worst nightmare. I just thought, my word, this is just horrendous. I look like a lizard having electroshock therapy.
I think it is a great idea.
Oh, yeah. Good. Yeah. OK, DJ, let's go.
Come on.
Go on.
That does.
Go on, Dan.
Yeah, that's the ticket.
Poor Dan was mortified. It wasn't a bit of him at all, was it? But bless him, he joined in and he done really well.
Oh, I'd stick to DJing, fella. Yeah, definitely stick to DJing.
It's been brilliant. We've had a really good week. And I can really see us all meeting up again and sort of, you know, going out.
It's not blind date.
What?
Like, we're definitely going to meet up again.
Right.
Sorry.
Come on, party time.
The night's not over yet. You've still got dessert to go. Paul and Claire go back to Jamaica with their ginger pudding.
I'm not confident about this one. It's just the taste of the ginger that I'm not sure that everyone's going to like.
Toffee sauce and ice cream added, it's ready. Jamaican ginger pudding with homemade ginger ice cream.
Here we are, Kate.
Ready? Thank you very much. Texture's lovely, nice crispy top. Toffee sauce is excellent. I like that. That's lovely.
That's wholesome. Oh. Absolutely awesome.
Great.
Yes, it's nice and moist is not a good word, is it?
No, it is, because the cake has to be moist. If it's too dry, it's horrible. So moist is a great word.
I personally love the pudding. I thought it was awesome.
Best one.
Was it better than Jackie's bread pudding?
The ginger ice cream was very nice. I enjoyed that. The toffee sauce was lovely.
I think we might have pulled it back. I definitely think it's still going to be close between
Simon and Jackie and us. I think it's too close to call.
Your guests will decide how close it is. Paul and Claire need 31 to win.
We've had a fantastic night. They're a lovely couple. We've really enjoyed their night. So tonight we're going to give them a 14.
Starter, unfortunately, was a bit hit and miss.
Yeah, the main courses, they didn't ask us how we wanted the steak to be cooked. So I think it was a vital thing for both of us not really enjoying it.
I really enjoyed the dessert, but it wasn't your cup of tea.
We've had a really, really great evening. They've been great hosts. So tonight we're going
to
score...
Hold it! It's up to our host to reveal the winners. Yay!
Here we go.
Here we go.
Woo! So, in joint second, we have Katie and Dan. And Paul and Claire. Jackie and Simon!
Dan and Katie scored an 11, meaning Jackie and Simon won by 5 points.
Thank you very much.
My.
I'll pull it after I call.
At least we weren't last. We were joint second, so. Yeah, not joint last, joint second, so it's perfect.
I wish now we could go back again and do it again.
Yeah, I think a bit more preparation would have seen us.
I did try and get you to prep a little bit more, but you wouldn't want to. So I'm going to blame you for the loss.
For more on Couples Come Down With Me, head to the Channel 4 website.
I'm going to take this money and spend it on a nice pair of designer shoes. And there you go, darling. There's your pocket money.
Hang on, I'll do the jokes.
Yeah, it's no joke. I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm